Hello everyone, and welcome to the first episode of Miracle Sudoku, a brand new game, just barely released. Let's get right into it. In non-consecutive Sudoku, every row, column, and box must have all numbers from 1 to 9 exactly once. In addition, two directly adjacent cells cannot contain consecutive numbers. For example, if one cell contains a 5, the four neighboring cells cannot contain a 4 or a 6. So we can use that right away to slot a 6 into those spots, thanks to this 6, which gives this 6. So it's a very cool sort of puzzle. For instance, the 7, there cannot be a 6 there, so thanks to those two 6s, we can actually do some more pencil marks. Looking at 1s in this block forces a 1 up there. We know a 1 can't go next to a 2. So 1s are actually going to be weaker. 1s and 9s, because they won't have as many restrictions. 9s are only restricted by 8s, and 1s are only restricted by 2s. 4 can't go next to a 3. So we can jot that down. 4 can't go next to a 3 or a 5, which gives two numbers there. A little bit surprisingly. Let's see, there's no 2s in the puzzle, but we know that 2 can't go next to a 3 or a 1. Actually, there's a 2 there. 2 can't go next to a 1 or a 3. Wow. So 2s are where I was supposed to look. And we can use the X-wing rule. Basically, there's nowhere a 2 can go in this column except for here. Because wherever a 2 ends up in this square, and wherever a 2 ends up in this square, they block out all of that area. So we get a 2 for the central block. It's not super duper useful. Let's look at the 1-7. And no 8s, but we do have a 6. And the 6. The 6s are in very useful spots. That 6 forces a 7 here, and that 6 forces a 7 down this column, and down that column. Now we still need a 5 here, and it can't go next to a 6. 5 cannot go next to a 4 as well. The remaining numbers here are 8 and 9. And the 9 seals the deal. And the 9s also force 9 here, which forces 2 here. So now we're just going super fast. And the 8! Look at that! 8 is unfilled on this row, and it can't go next to a 7. So we can finish off that entire row. Next to a 2. So we actually do get another double sword, as I like to call it, forcing a 1 in that column over there. And now this block is missing a 7 and an 8, 7 cannot go next to a 6. So that is the 7, and that is the 8. 8 can't go next to a 9. And now 7 can't go next to a 8. Look at how it, like, builds on itself. It's crazy. And this block, 7 can't go next to an 8, and we've got this 1-4 pair. So that forces a 7 there. Looking at this block, it still needs a 1, still needs a 2, and it also needs a 3. So the 3s and the 5s are overlapping, which forces the 1 up there, I think. To a 6, so that's the 5 and that's the 3. So now we've got this entire middle box filled in basically, which is pretty cool. So we've got 1-4, we need 2 in here, we need 5 in here, the 5 can't go next to a 6. And we need 9 in here, and the 9 can't go next to an 8, and there's a 9 there. So that's a 9, that's a 2, that's a 5. 5 can't go next to a 4. Nines are super restrictive, and yet I am still looking at them. Who knows why? Got 5 and 9 in the same thing. There also needs to be a 2 somewhere. Oh, it is restricted by the 1, so that's a little bit restricted. Ah, these 9s are in like a diagonal thing, so I can't get anything out of them. But we've got that settled, so now there needs to be a 6 somewhere in here. 1, 2, 3. 3 can't go next to the 4. Oops. And it needs a 6 as well. An 8. 8 can't go next to a 7. So the 8s and the 6s double up. That's the only place a 3 can go. Now 3 is forced up there. Sorry if my voice sounds kind of gravelly. Probably because I ate all that gravel yesterday. Just kidding, I didn't even eat gravel. You guys got jebaited. Alright, where should I look next? Needs to be a 4 somewhere in this row. Let's look at 5s. Sevens, maybe. 7 has to be in one of those 3 spots. I may actually be stuck here, let's see. stuck in the first puzzle, shaking my head. Now I'm just looking like, is there any non-consecutive thing I missed? Like threes, for instance, can't go. In those spots, is that important? All those spots are already covered. What's really interesting is that blocks like these are surrounded by threes and fours in this like diamond shape. There might be something about the surroundings that ends up mattering. Like, since this is only a 4-8, there can't be a 7 in this block. 6 or 8, that can't be a 7 no matter which it ends up being. Things down to like 2 spaces so I could notate it, that would be great. Okay, so here's what I'm thinking. Wherever the 1 ends up being, there can't be a 2 next to it. So since it's down to like 2 spaces, there can't be a 2 in either of those spots. Is that useful? Well, there can't be a 2 next to the 3, and there can't be a 2 next to the 1, like I said. Oh, and there can't be a 2 next to that 3. That must be what I was supposed to see. So now, here's here, and then the 3's here. So in between where the 2 goes, there can't be a 3 or a 1, which comes into play here, because now this can't be a 3. That might be the breakthrough I needed. 3 can't be next to 2 there. So now this can't be 4 on either of those spaces. So it doesn't quite do enough. This can't be a 4. Interesting little set. Any 8s? I haven't looked at 8s in forever. Yeah, in the bottom right box, 8 can't go next to a 9. Can't go next to a 9, perfect. let's take another look at this box now that it's so empty. Four in this box now. Somewhat restrictive. It's like if this was 1 or 3, it would lock out a 2. Okay, so this row needs 1, 4. That's 6. So 6 in this block is really restrictive. Where else? 6 can't be next to 5 or 9. 5 or 7. It's not restrictive enough in that box. So if 6 is here, then the space couldn't be 7 or 5. I think it'd be forced into being 2. Again, I want to know if 9s restrict 1s. Because if that was the case, then these 1s would disqualify 9 from that space. Which could be important. This row, we know where the 1 goes. So I'm thinking, like, if the 2's here, that 2's here, those end up being the 3's. still need to put 6 somewhere in there. Take a quick break, go order some food, and then come back to this puzzle. What does this mean? In any case, I shall see you momentarily. Alright, it's been like a few hours, let's see if I can still play this game. I almost clicked new. So even if the 4 is arranged like this, that still means there can't be a 5 or a 3 here, so the 5 might matter. I don't see it, but the 5 in this row is limited. This space can't be a 4 because it's sandwiched between. No, it doesn't look like that. That's too far away. It can only be. Can't be a 3 or a 1. So 4 can be in any space here, as can 1. 6 the same. Six can go. else is missing in this box? 1, 4, 7, 2. 5 is missing. There's so many nines, and yet it's like not restricted at all. By the time I solve this, I'm gonna be a super genius, I bet. Alright, I'm gonna look through everything, see if there's something I missed. Says 4, 6, it'll be okay. 4, 5, it'll be okay. 5 and 6, it'll be okay. That can't be a 4 anymore. Restricts 5 in this box. That space can't be a 5. Is that useful? Thank you. not super scientific. Thank you. total loss. I'm gonna go eat pizza. The third attempt, it is like 2 days later. take the code face value, that's a fine. Considering that's all we needed, I'd still say it's a pretty legit victory. Thanks for watching.